Police are investigating the whereabouts of missing 4-year-old Aiden Dolor of Soufriere. According to reports on Saturday, Aiden went wandering from his abode to the Soufriere Beach Park and hasn't been seen since. Family and friends are concerned and are seeking the assistance of the public in locating Aiden. Aiden's mother, Amanda Dolor, recounts what transpired during the moment of her 4-year-old son's disappearance on Saturday, January 21st.
When I saw him, he was inside with his brother on the chair, and I went in the room and took a pencil and I put it on, and I went to the kitchen and my sister was there cooking, and he told Aiden, "You will get food." Then she asked me, "Where is his bowl?" I tell her, "I go in and get the bowl." And once I get the bowl, she come back and she tell me she haven't seen Aiden.
My niece called me and tell me that they can't find my nephew. So I was like, can't find my nephew. So I left home immediately and I came here to ask them what's the situation. But when I came here, everybody was spread out looking for him already. So my first suggestion was to go by the beach because I know he loves the water. For him, the beach is his favorite place to be. So that was the first place everybody went to look. So we went there, different people went and questioned people by the beach. Apparently, a lot of people said they didn't see him, which now we know isn't the case. Being said that we have seen the camera footage, that he was actually there, and you can see there were people by the beach. To be honest, I cannot even express how we're feeling because he's a child to make. He's everybody. He's the light of the family, I would say. He's the last one in the family and he's the light of the family. Everybody will come there and he will make everybody laugh and everything. So my auntie, that's the first person she would check when she come home and things. So everybody know him.
Aiden is also autistic, which according to the family has presented several challenges during his growth. The family would oftentimes have difficulty keeping him contained in the yard. Aiden's aunt says the family is hopeful for answers surrounding his disappearance as he is sorely missed.
We are just waiting on the updates from the authority, and the search, as I know of, is still currently going on. But we as a family, we're hoping to know where we can find him, or if he actually was by the beach, if we can find if he's dead or something, at least find a body so that we can get closure, then instead of we not knowing the unknown for years upon years. I think that would be better on us, the family.
That's the first thing I do when I get home, whether I'm coming from town or from work. He's the first person I would ask for. Where's Aiden? I would call him, Papois, my mom is here. And he would just look at me. If he's watching his TV, he'll look at me and smile. I walk to my room, he'll come by and he'll just touch me and go back to his device.
Aiden's teacher says the school environment is not the same with him missing, and students are still trying to understand the situation.
This morning at our devotion assembly period, I mentioned to the children, if they know what happened over the weekend, and they said that a child got lost. And then I told them, well, it is one of ours, Aiden. And they said, yes, I remember Aiden, you know. But I think the parents did a good job by letting them know that he's the one at the center and stuff like that. He can articulate. That's one of the problems. He doesn't articulate, but he understands. He followed directives by the facilitator and so on. But he responds with a smile when he's spoken to. So that's one of the attributes that make the others, the staff, reminds him with a special smile that is unique and so on. And he likes to sleep. When he finished his activity, he would go to the court and fall asleep.
Aiden's aunt calls for an end to public speculation surrounding the incident. Instead, she says efforts should be made to locate the missing 4-year-old.
I would like people to stop speculating rumors because we as a family, the situation is very painful, and listening to other people just make up stories about what happened and they don't know how we feel, it isn't helping us, being that everybody has their own medical issues and stuff. So,
CCTV cameras captured Aiden walking through the Soufriere Beach Park on Saturday, January 21st. Aiden was last seen wearing a purple shirt and grey pants. Anyone with information regarding Aiden's whereabouts is asked to call the Soufriere Police Station at 456-6320. For the DBS News World, Jason Darius reporting.